wife went out of town about a year or so back and left me home by myself to batch, and after five straight nights of TV, I was ready to scream. So I called up this beer-drinking buddy of mine. I said, Bill, I ain't having a real good time. He said, well, why don't we go to wrestling matches and let off a little steam? Well, now, I'd never seen the matches before, and when we reached that arena door, the crowd was already backed up plumb out in the street. Yeah, people were pushing and shoving like cattle. Just getting in line was a heck of a battle. We had to fight like the devil, but we finally got ringside seats. We bought a program as we passed through the door, went to Section D, seats 3 and 4, and about that time, the announcer stepped in the ring. He said, tonight's the greatest card ever been signed. Got a tag team match, it'll blow your mind. And then they lowered the lights and the crowd began to scream. He introduced the Spider from parts unknown with his trusted partner, the Blue Cyclone, and they were taking on a team that never had been beat. And then the ref checked them over and the rules were explained, and somebody hollered, the Spider's got a chain! And then in came the Vulture with his manager, Sneaky Pete. Well, they rang the bell and all hell broke loose. My legs were shaking like a rubber goose. I ain't never seen nothing like this, not even in the war. The Cyclone put the Vulture in an airplane spin. Then he body slammed him and he did it again. I swear I didn't see how that old boy could take much more. There was this little old lady right next to me. If she was a day, she was 83, but she raised more sand than any man I've ever seen. Yeah, she screamed and cussed in the Cyclone's face till they carried her out like a basket case. Then the police came and formed a circle round the ring. It was right about then, in the thick of things, my buddy Bill threw a chair in the ring, and that's when I knew we better be heading for the door. Because I saw that Cyclone looking at us, and he's rubbing his head and starting to cuss, and I knew if he caught us, he'd break Bill's neck for sure. Well, now, where we parked wasn't too far, and Bill ran so fast he beat me to the car and locked the doors. Wasn't about to let anybody in. And I turned around, and the Cyclone was there, and he said, hey, punk, you forgot your chair. And by the look in his eyes, I knew this was the end. So I screamed, watch it, pal. I run a school where I teach karate and jujitsu. But before I could finish, he gave my teeth a rake. Yeah, and then he jumped up real high in the air and both feet caught me with a flying mare. Now tell me again how all that wrestling's fake. And then he body slammed me 2 or 3 times and put his arms around me from behind and pile-drive me right there in the hard concrete. Broke both my arms and 3 of my ribs. It's the closest I've ever come to being killed, and that's the last thing I remember before he put me to sleep.
Cyclone.
He's the meanest wrestler the ring has ever known. He'll make you groan, he'll make you moan, he'll lay you prone and break your bones. He's a Blue Cyclone.
Cyclone.
Blue Cyclone.
Cyclone.
I'm